1927. As it happened, and then if the levees had not broke, then that's the top mark. And the 2011 57.1 mark is just above the 1927 as it happened. Right now, this is low flow for the Ezra River. We're just getting into the dry part of the season, so it may get just a little bit lower. But the Ezra River is controlled by the Mississippi River at pretty much all stages.
All right, I got it. Hold this thing, Mickey. Let's go. Run hook.
Welcome aboard the Ernie Boswell.
What you're seeing is the flow of the Yazoo River coming out, and as it hits the Mississippi River just cuts it off like a knife and takes it, you know, downstream. And that's the line between the Yazoo River. We're sitting in Yazoo River water. That's Mississippi River water about 50 feet out there, and that's the transition stage between the two different sets of water.
Well, this is one of the USGS's National Monitoring Network sites, the Mississippi River at Vicksburg. We sample this site 12 times a year as a part of that network. As a part of that sampling, we make discharge measurements using a ADCP, which is a Doppler, to measure the discharge and the velocity. After that, we also use the Doppler to keep us aware of the depth changes on this river as we're sending down one of our depth integrated samplers. So as we sample this river 12 times a year, we basically come over, we measure the discharge, we take a depth integrated sample with one of our bag samplers that is approved to sample at these larger depths, which can range anywhere from 40 feet here at Vicksburg to as much as 170 feet that we saw in the 2011 flood. So this is our measuring section downstream of the Yazoo River. Today, we're probably looking at velocities somewhere 4, 5, 6 foot a second, moderate depths, probably anywhere from 20 feet to one side and out to about 60 feet. In the 2011 flood, we had velocities as high as that we recorded 17 foot a second, and the maximum depth was somewhere around 170 feet, but that's the change in conditions that you see here. So this is the software that we use to record and track the ADCP measurement that we're going to make. All of this is being collected electronic right now. We're getting actually real-time latitude longitude vectors that correspond with each transect of the Doppler measurement. We use a USGS approved sampler for this depth and velocity. Today this is a D96 bag sampler. Teflon equipment on all of the equipment that touches the river water. That equipment's cleaned every time we use it, reduce any type of contamination. So this is a moving boat method sample. So we try to keep the boat steady as possible in the flow by using the Doppler, looking at the position of the boat with the bottom track, and of course the satellites that are hooked up, recording the latitude, longitude, So this is our Teflon bag inside of our D96 tray, sampling tray that slides into the sample.
It just slides in and locks in place. Now I'm gonna go back out. I've opened up the bag so that it doesn't have a static electricity hold together, pushed all the air out of it. You should be ready to sample now.
All right, so we got 47 foot.
I'm gonna go down 45.
Okay. 43. 43.3, 43.0. So this is the only true way to really gather water data on the Mississippi River, rivers of this size, using this type of technology. Because what we'd like to do is we would like to get a snapshot of the water from the right bank to the left bank, from top to bottom, and a subsample that we can use to divide out other samples for constituents that we want to look at.
That there's about 2 liters.
It's a good sample. So that's a composite sample from top to bottom at this section that represents this percentage of flow on this side of the river. So we'll use that sample composite with the other samples we take across the river to get our composited sample for the river. So it's not a simple thing. A lot of people think that when you sample water that it's a simple task, that all you need is just maybe a dip off the top or a sample here and there, but that doesn't give you an entire picture of what's going on in the river. You actually have to sample from bank to bank and top to bottom. Sampling with these samplers, you can do that. It actually starts sampling as soon as it goes into the water, all the way to the bottom, and then back up to the top, where the water's actually flowing into that sampler at the same rate that the water's moving down the stream or the river.
I might want to just have a handle.